must have noticed. The second person will be Tracy. I feel I don't know her. I think she has made a conscious decision to use a limited vocabulary of phrases. By having a limited set of answers, you don't have to say too much. By, say, having it, or I'm having, or do it, and I've noticed, you know, this, I don't remember all her phrases. I'm sure, you know, she's got her own fan club and people are writing down her phrases already. But they don't constitute a normal conversation you could have with a human being.
...4:34 PM. Some of the housemates are in the garden. So far, Amanda and Jerry have nominated. Carol, Nikki, Shabnam and Tracy have all received one nomination each. Jerry is in the bathroom. It's been 4 minutes since he nominated.
It's only kidding. It's not serious.
I'll just do it every day, because Sam...
Would Sam come to the diary room?
No! The first nomination, I'm going to say Shabs. Looking at it like from like a group thing, because like we're all in this together, because we've all been given assigned jobs to do, and like we can all see how she hasn't really been taking on the jobs. Maybe Shabnam doesn't really do many jobs in the home, like if she lives with her mum, stuff like I don't really do many jobs at home. Maybe she just like might be just thinking like, oh, I'll just leave it until like I'm told to do it, do you know what I mean? When we've had these meetings, I don't know if she takes fully into like consideration what has actually been said. For example, like at night time, we all agreed that in the room we should be quiet, because I saw on one occasion she'd come in the bedroom and then she'd come in breathing really heavily, like that, and then running out and laughing and waking everyone up, and then coming in when everyone's asleep and going, a wimba what, like, and it's like dad bad intentional to wake everyone up. It's not like she's just talking to other people, like, so it is that intentional to wake people up or get on people's nerves or something, I don't know.
Now, could you give the name of your second nomination and explain your reasons for this nomination?
My second nomination is Carol, because when we're having group meetings, I can have my hand up for ages, so I can be like, but, like this, and everyone's doing that, and like people didn't get listened to until ages, because like there's so many other people speaking. But when Carol's like, she just walks off out of the meeting, and if people are going to walk off, then nothing's going to get sorted. I think she thinks that people didn't want to listen to her, but really it's because everyone's like that, because everyone's trying to get their opinion. I think me and other people in the group just found it really frustrating and quite like ignorant to just walk off, because like I didn't know why you would walk off in a group meeting. It's quite rude.
Give me a hug. I don't like you.
You okay?
Yeah.
It is against Big Brother rules for housemates to discuss their nominations.
I'm not sure at all about my nominations today. The second one was just, you know, a last minute. And one of the reasons I nominated this person was because I thought the public likes this person anyway, so this person will stay. Sometimes, you know, it's different though to be likable on telly, and different to be likable when you live with these people. Yeah. That's why I try to run away, because I don't like to force my... When I'm upset, I don't like to force it to the other and, you know, make the whole group feel shit because I'm feeling a bit shitty.
You're back now, you're back.
Yeah, I'm back. You know, it's over, you
listen,
know.
Listen, it's a whole...
It's only game. Everything's going to be okay. I don't know
Everyone goes, it's a game. It is a game, but at the end of the day, you have to live with these people.
Yes.
That's it.
This is Big Brother. Could Shawnee come to the diary room?
No, I'll put that one. first nomination is going to be Tracy. I feel that she doesn't really sort of take part in all the fun. You know, she's got a wise head on her whenever you need to speak to her about particular issues. But she responds to a lot of other people with, you know, just deal with it. Just deal with it. And, you know, it's quite hard to just deal with it, you know. They need each other and, you know, they need the support from the other housemates. And Tracy doesn't seem to really need that support. I haven't really seen her join in any, you know, like, if we're playing any games and stuff. Tracy just seems to come out, have a smoke, wander about, go back into the room. So I think maybe some people are afraid they ask her if she wants to join in the fun. Because they think she's going to maybe snap at them, or, you know, they just expect that she's going to say no anyway.
Could you give the name of your second nomination and explain your reasons for this nomination?
I'm going to nominate Shabnam because she seems to cause conflict within the group. She says that she says things in jest, but how she delivers them isn't really that funny. She seems to not take responsibility for her own actions whenever she's been given chores and she doesn't complete them. Can be a bit immature. There was discussion about tidying up, and a lot of the housemates said to Shabnam, you know, she didn't tidy up, and Shabnam started, you know, raising her voice to them and wasn't really listening to what they were trying to say to her. It was causing a bit of friction amongst the group. Just how she deals with the situation, like she'll shout back at them and, you know, try to justify herself, and she hasn't really been pulling her weight around the house.
There's so many guys out there, you know, that are going to be there when we get out.
That's true.
And the wait is so worth it, Nick.
Yeah, but imagine, like, if you got out of the house and you met someone, like, me and Zach kind of situation, and then I got out of the house, and I said to Zach, oh, no, I don't like you. Oh, I do like you, but I want to see what's on the outside world first. Got on the outside world and was like, oh, no, I really couldn't stop thinking about him and stuff. And then he was like, too late now, you fucked me off before.
But then don't forget also that somebody in this situation will appear more attractive to you because of the environment, because of the pressurised environment. Just don't get carried away, Shannon.
No, I'm not going to. I've got my head screwed on.
Please don't.
Yeah.
It's really hard when you like someone not to fall, but
the thing is, like, he's said more stuff to me than I've said to him. And he's...
But you know, also be a bit little wary of that as well. Don't be too naive. He might be saying all this stuff, so you don't nominate him. Sorry, honey, but it's bottom line. He might be. Don't repeat this to him. This is between... This is girly chat.
Oh, yeah, this is good. She would well.
But I'd be saying it to you if we were on the outside. But just be so careful.
With three nominations, Shabnam will face a public vote, as will Carol and Tracy, who each received two nominations. Nikki received one nomination. Amanda, Chanel, Charlie, Jerry, Laura, Sam, Shawnee and Ziggy didn't receive a single nomination. Big Brother will tell the housemates the results of the nominations later in the week. 8:53 p.m. Charlie, Amanda, Sam, Shawnee and Laura are in the bedroom.
Has there ever been a time where you've seen so much pink you felt like exploded?
No.
No.
Never.
Are you going to call your firstborn pink?
Ziggy and Chanel are in the bathroom. It's been 3 hours and 54 minutes since Chanel talked about Ziggy with Charlie, Laura and Nikki in the garden.
It's gone well, Stacey. I'm interested. I'm not going to say anything.
Not hardly anything, just, like,
yeah,
course, I said to them.
You don't know me, you have to be careful. But I don't, you know, I'm not going here to hurt you. I'm not. What's the point for me?
No, I said to them, I goes, oh, well, don't worry, I goes. We both agree that we think it's better that now I'm staying with the twins and Zach's in his own bed because...